So in my previous videos, I have explained in detail about the way of solving the problems on edges. Now in this video, let me tell you the shortcut method of getting an answer of edges within a fraction of a second. So to do that, I have considered one example. Let's have a look over that. So this problem will be solved first with a traditional method, and then after I will explain you the shortcut of getting the answer for this question. So watch this video till the end. Now look at the question here. The age of a lady is thrice the age of her son. 5 years ago, age of son is 1/6 of father's age. If his father age is 5 years elder from his mother. So father is 5 years elder from his mother. Then find the present age of the son. So traditionally, let us solve it traditionally now. So traditionally in this sense, we have to try to get an expressions here. So look at the statement and write that. So the age of a lady is thrice the age of her son, and finally you need to find the age of a son. So let us consider the age of son as x, that is a present age. Okay, present age. So it is in present sense. So first let us consider the present conditions. So mother age, what would be the mother age? The age of lady is thrice age of son. So mother age will become 3 times of x if I consider son as x. Then 5 years ago, so they are talking about past. So before going to that, let me write one more condition. That is, if his father age is 5 years elder from his mother. So father is 5 years elder from his mother. So based on that, I can write father will be, mother age is 3x, and father will be 5 years elder than mother. So 3x plus 5. So this is the statement with respect to the present condition. But here we have one more statement, that is 5 years ago. That is nothing but past. So in past, 5 years ago, the age of son is 1/6 of father's age. So that is the statement. So what would be the age of son 5 years ago? It will be present age minus 5. So present age is x. I will consider it as a son age will be x minus 5. Okay, so father's age will be 3x plus 5 minus 5. It is 5 years ago. So plus 5 minus 5 will get cancelled and we get it as 3x. Okay, right. Now, there is one more condition, that is the age of son will be 1/6 of father's age. That is 5 years ago, whatever the age he is going to have, that will be equal to 1/6 of father's age. So I can write the relation like this. X minus 5 will be equal to 1/6 times of father's age 5 years ago. So what is 5 years ago? 3x. So if you simplify this, we get x minus 5 here and this will be 3 1s are 3 2s are 1/2 times of x. Therefore I can write it here. So what happens here? This 2 will be taken to the LHS side, so 2 into x, it will be 2x minus 2, 5 is 10, equal to x. So if I take x to the LHS side, 2x minus x, it will be 1x is equal to 10, I will take it to the RHS. So 10. So x is nothing but the age of son. We got the answer. So option A will be the answer. So this is about the traditional method. It will take some time. Now let us have a look over the shortcut method. So I will just write it here. So for shortcut method, what you need to do is, you should look into the options here. Based on the question, what happens, we will look into the option and we will take that option and try to get it easily. Okay. So first let me take the first option, that is 10. So son age, I will consider it as, age of son, I will consider it as 10. Instead of x, I will consider the option now, 10. And according to the statement, mother is thrice the age of, mother age is thrice the age of son. So according to that, what happens, 3 times of 10. That is 30. Mother age will be 30. And father is 5 years elder than mother. So father age will be 35. And then 5 years ago, they are talking about the past. 5 years ago, the age of son is 1/6 of father's age. So you can take it as minus 5. 5 years ago, the age of son will be 5. And the 5 years ago, the age of father will be minus 5. So 30. And now you need to check that whether this is 1/6 time of a father's age or not. So we can say 5 is equal to 1/6 times of 30. Is it matching? Yes. 6 1 is 6 5 is a. So this option is correct. First option is correct. So this is how, without getting all this expression, you can get the answer. Just what you need to do is, you have to get the option, consider the option and apply it according to the conditions, according to the given question. This will be a short trick. Now what we do, we'll take second question and there that question will be solved by using only a short trick here. I will not explain with the traditional. So let's have a look over the second question. So the sum of ages of a man and his son is 45. So sum of age of man and son is 45. 5 years ago, the product of their ages is equal to 4 times of his father's age. So when we take past 5 years, the product of their ages will be equal to 4 times of his father's age at that time, at the past. So the ages of father and son respectively are. So options are given here. So I will not solve it by the traditional method as I told you. So let's start with the shortcut. So while solving the shortcut, first look at all the options and see whether all these options are valid or not. Okay, instead of taking the first option, look at the statement here. See, it depends upon completely statement. So this statement says that sum of ages of man and his son is 45. So here itself we can avoid some of the options, because the sum should be 45. Here, yes, I get sum as 45. 35 plus 10 is 45. Here also it will be 45. But when we add these two, it will not be 45. So automatically what we need to do is, by just looking into this, in your mind you should understand that these two are not valid options. So these two are vanished. Now remaining only two options we have. From these two, let's take the first one. Okay, and always it is not sure that the first option will be the right option. Okay, so let's check it. So 35 and 10. So father's age is 35, and I'll consider the son, age of son is 10. And now see whether it is correct or wrong. So how to do it? So the sum should be 45. It is satisfying that condition. That's okay. 5 years ago, the product of their ages is equal to 4 times of his father's age. So that's the statement. So 5 years ago means minus 5, minus 5. So it will be 30. This is going to be 5. The product of their ages is equal to 4 times. So first find the product of their ages. 30 into 5 is 150. It is 150. Is it equal to 4 times of his father's age? So father's age is 30. So it is 30 into 4 times. So it will be not equal, because it will be 120. So these two is not equal. So this option is also not valid. Now we have only one option left out. So this will be the right answer. And if you want to cross check it, you can do it as. So consider father and son. That is also a shortcut method. Using a shortcut method, we can do it. 36 and 9. So 5 years ago. So minus 5, minus 5. 31, and this will be 4. So the product of this should be equal to 4 times of father's age. Now no need to even multiply it, because 31 into 4, it is product of 4. And so it will be equal to the 4 times of his father's age. So it will be 124, and even if I multiply same, you will get 124. So option is 9. Option is 36 and 9. This is how you can get the answers within a fraction of seconds. So you have to observe the options given and relate it to the statement given. Then we can avoid some of the which are not related to the question. Some of the unwanted options can be removed easily, and from the remaining options we can find very in a fast manner. Okay, I hope this concept is clear for you. If it is clear, like and comment on this video, and also share among your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you.